Hi, it's Peter with the education department at the Omaha Zoo. We flooded the home studio with water, and I'm surrounded by sharks underwater at home so that you can learn about sharks. Hi, welcome to another edition of Zoo from Home. Today, we're talking about sharks, which are a special kind of fish called an elasmobranch. That's a big fancy word, and it means that sharks have cartilage instead of bones. You can feel the difference if you feel the bone in your elbow. Feel how hard that bone is? Now feel the cartilage in your ears. That's a lot softer. If you think about how skulls look around Halloween, remember skulls don't have noses or ears because the bone is the skull and your nose and ears are cartilage. We sometimes think about sharks like there's just a couple different kinds of sharks, but actually there are more than 400 different species of sharks. The smallest never get bigger than a foot long even when they're all grown up. And the biggest shark is as big as a school bus. Those are called whale sharks. The last time I was at the zoo, I counted more than 10 different species of sharks just in the Scott Aquarium. How many species of sharks can you name? One of the coolest sharks in the world you can find at our zoo, usually lying motionless at the bottom of the aquarium. I've been asked multiple times if these sharks are okay because they hold so still. They're called nurse sharks. And what makes them so cool is not only can they pump water over their gills so that they don't have to keep swimming to keep breathing, but they can pump so much they can suck in the animals that they eat if they just get near their faces. They don't actually have to chase them and grab them.
Baby shark doo-doo-doo-doo, baby shark doo-doo-doo-doo, baby shark doo-doo-doo-doo-doo.
For today's game, we are going to play a true or false game about sharks. I'm going to tell you something about sharks, and if you think the answer is true, reach your hands up to the sky. But if you think the answer is false, reach your hands down to the ground. First question, true or false? At the zoo, all of those small fish are the food for the big sharks. What do you think? That is false. We feed the sharks twice per week, and that's enough food that they leave all the other fish in the tank alone. Okay, how about this one? True or false? Sometimes people actually go swimming in the shark tank at the zoo with all those big sharks. What do you think? That's true, yeah. The only way we can clean that tank is from the inside. We've never had a problem with the sharks harassing our divers. But you know what? In the whole world, you've probably heard about sharks attacking people. We're pretty proud here in Nebraska. We actually have a perfect record. There has been not one single death caused by sharks in the entire history of the state of Nebraska. Yeah, take that, Florida. So, what do you think? Around the whole world, do sharks kill more than 100 people per year? Or do they kill less than 100 people per year? What do you think? Way less than 100 people per year. On average, around the entire world, only about 10 people are killed by sharks. People are not the main food for sharks. Sharks just don't really want to eat people. It's not a big problem. But what about sharks being killed by people? Do you think that more than 10 million sharks are killed by people every year? Or do you think less than 10 million sharks are killed by people? It's actually way more than 10 million. About 100 million sharks are killed every year. That's a really big deal because sharks, in most places, are an apex predator. They're the top of the food chain. And they're being taken out of the oceans faster than they're reproducing, which is leading to problems with all species in the ocean. Most of those sharks are actually being killed for something called shark fin soup. So they're often being killed illegally, the fins are sliced off, and the shark is thrown back to die. This is a big, big problem, and you can help by not purchasing shark meat and by making sure that whenever you do buy fish at the grocery store, you look for only sustainably harvested fish. You can find information about that by downloading the Seafood Watch app for your phone or visiting their website. Thank you so much, everyone, for tuning in today. I hope you had a lot of fun with us, and we'll see you next time. Bye, everyone.